So here ceramic. So we'll talk about ceramic. So in the ceramic material main use, so we are seeing, right? So it is a economical and cheap. Cheap in the cost. That's where main use is the ceramic. That is the inorganic material and produced by concentrated material into the monolith bodies. Okay. So it is a high temperature heat treatment. So it is a combined. So it will well when constructing manufacturing, it will use it for high temperature. So ceramic can be into two groups based upon the it's a dielectric converted low permeability ceramics and with the high permeability. Okay, so which have the low permeability, okay, that will using as insulator. High permeability ceramics used in the capacitors. So as a transfer, so based upon application, okay, and viewer value, that it will be referred to two types. One is a low permeability, another one is the high permeability. Okay, so low permeability material used in the insulations, high permeability used for the capacitors. Okay, and the dielectrical properties, if you take them, okay, so how it will be vary. So low permeability ceramics, so based upon the atmospheric condition, okay, and acid value, okay, so some factors will be affected, the Muir value, okay, whatever the Muir value, the some factors will be affected, that will be if you take so you can see the in this table the low permeability ceramics, so how it will be varies for HT and LT lines, okay, low loss satellites, aluminum, okay, that will be you can see based upon the effect, okay, and the chemical effect, how it will be differed, and strength, temperature, okay. So for low permeability ceramics, how will it be different? Okay, it is a composition. So chemical components, how much is there? Okay, how much clay will be used for LT and HT? Okay, you can see, and how much water permit? Okay, for while making. Okay, and temperature withstand for low and high. Okay, you can see. So you know about the plastic, right? So plastic is having a different type. Okay, so plastic also one of the type of the insulating material, as will be used for dielectrical material, as well as used for the insulating material. So here if we talk about the we have to take the three topics. One is that's dielectrical term. So the dielectrical term, if you talk about that, is 172,000 cubic, but mainly we are not using the polished. Okay, so plastics we are not used because it is only tearable. Okay, so we'll combine the plastic material with the polymers. Okay, so we are using the polymers for gears. Okay, some of them for holding. Okay, so plastic we are not directly, so we are using thermoplastics, right? Okay, so whatever the plastics, there are different types. So thermostatic plastic we are having, thermostatic. Okay, so we are having best. And one more thing, so it will have been the high temperature itself. So while using the high temperatures, what we have, so we have to take care while application. Okay, so you have to select the suitable applications for it. Okay, how much losses, dielectrical losses, or how much withstanding. Okay, that we have to consider. So here what we are doing, so just we have to know the how much. So first we have to know the where we are using. Okay. So if you have any examinations purpose for, okay, so we have to know the which applications we are using. Next, dielectrical constant, okay, that we have to know, and what are the voltage levels, okay, how much breakdown strength is there, okay, that we have to know. So the three points we have to write while writing the about the dielectrical material, okay, in liquid, gases and solids. So if you talk about the rubber, so rubber is a vulcanized rubber, right? So we are using mainly in the high voltage engineering and electrical engineering. So without rubber insulation metal, we cannot use the diff. Okay, so we are not able to run the electrical machine. So with the rubber material only we are using the insulation, while taking from the conductor, insulating material, variable. So in that mainly plays the main role in the electrical material. Okay, that is the rubber. So the rubber, whatever they have, so the electrical strength is that is a 80 to 390 kV per centimeter. And the temperature with this time, that is a low temperature having the 60 degrees to 150. So above with that, we are using, so above 8 degrees, what we have to use. So for above, it will be using for the polymers, okay? And some of the application, that is the epoxy resins, okay? So for, if not using the rubbers, what we are using, epoxy resins on polymers for using, okay?